This is our 5 minutes or less quick styling how-to. We've pre-curled our model Tracy's hair with a hot bar just to give it that soft, beachy wave. Now, Tracy is a busy mom and a busy business owner, so we want to show her how to do something really fun and current and very easy to do at home. So I'm going to start with gathering her hair together really loose in my hands and slightly off to the side. So I want to follow the shape of the curls that we previously set in. So I'm going to use a little bit of a light spray shine and slowly rake my fingers through it just to give it a little bit of separation. So I'm going to start with your basic 3-strand braid. For those of you that don't know how to do a basic braid at home, you're going to take the hair and divide it into 3 equal sections. And it's as simple as just overlapping the hair. So I'm going to start with the right side and I'm going to overlap right over middle. Let's get a little of that tangle out down there. And left over middle. And I'm just going to repeat that same process all the way down. So right over middle, left over middle. Now once I get to the end, this is where the fun starts. We're going to take this basic 3-strand braid and we're going to use our fingers to lightly pull out some soft pieces to give it a soft textured feel. So I'm going to use my forefinger and my thumb and I'm going to lightly pull out little loops of the hair. Now if you pull it out all the way and you get a loose end, don't worry because this is meant to look really soft. So I'm going to, same thing just like here, I'm going to pull a little bit of that out. And I'm just going to create some loops in that braid and pull those soft pieces out. So you can see it gives us a really pretty, soft, textured braid. And I'm going to use a small rubber band to secure the ends together. I'm just going to double that over. So you can see, pretty easy. Now from here, we're just gonna fold this up and secure it with some bobby pins. So I'm gonna roll it up and bring it around and I'm just gonna tuck the end of that braid right there. Now here's where we're gonna bring in our bobby pins and we're just using your standard crimped bobby pin. So for those of you that don't know what a bobby pin looks like, these have a little bit of a pinch to them. So there'll be a flat end and a rippled end. Now when you're using your bobby pins, you really want to put the flat end towards the head, and it's important to grab a little bit of hair from both sections. Since I want to secure the braid to the hair behind it, I'm going to put the foot end of the bobby pin, which is the side with the flat end, and I'm going to loop that in the hair against her head, and I'm going to use the crimped end of the bobby pin and I'm going to slide that right in. And you should feel it right away that you have some security there. So what I want to do is I want to keep using bobby pins and I'm just going to work around until it feels secure where we tucked the end of that braid in. So once again, I'm going to use that flat end and I'm going to put that near her head and I'm going to grab some of that hair in the back and I'm going to use the front of the bobby pin and I'm going to grab the piece of the braid. So you can already see it starting to get a little bit more secure there. Once you secure the end of the braid, this is where you can be creative and you can start pulling the softer pieces together to finish it. So I'm just going to grab these loose pieces and I'm going to grab them with my 2 first fingers and I'm just going to softly fold them over and bring them to the end of the braid where we have them secured. And you can see I kind of transferred from my left hand to my right hand. That's just to give it a little bit of a fold and a little bit of a texture and give me some security so I know where to place my bobby pin. So I'm going to come back and I'm going to grab another bobby pin. And I'm going to do the same thing we did before. I'm going to use the flat end on the back of the hair and I'm going to use the front end to secure that loop that I'm holding in between my fingers. Now, for those of you who have a little bit more slippery hair where the bobby pin doesn't feel secure, a little trick how you can make that stay is by crisscrossing your bobby pins. So you come back in anywhere you placed a bobby pin, like that one right there, and I'm gonna take another bobby pin and I'm just gonna crisscross it right over top. That just helps lock it in place and gives it a little bit more security. So from here, I'm just gonna randomly grab some of these loose pieces and just eyeball where I want it to go. And I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm just gonna use my fingers to fold it up and bring it to that same location. And use those bobby pins to secure it. Now, as you can see, we've got the main part of the form right here. And as we turn Tracy a little bit, you can see we still have this soft, drapey hair to deal with. So from here, we're gonna use that same technique. Since the hair's been pre-curled, it's already doing a lot of the work for us. So we're just gonna grab a couple loose sections, let the hair tell us where it wants to go, and lightly drape it over to that same point where all of our other bobby pins are. So once again, I'm gonna use that same technique with the bobby pin, and I'm gonna use the flat side of the bobby pin towards her head, and I'm gonna use the clamp side to secure that hair. I'm gonna repeat that same motion just a couple more times to get up these loose pieces. So let's turn her around a little bit here so you can see. This is a really current style. It's very soft, it's very easy, and takes less than 5 minutes.